Yiratzon Parshat Vayeshev pre Hanukkah 5779 Yiratzon the Limud should be the Refuat Kol Acholim V'Tocham Tanya B'Toda Maglit Yosef Yaron Aviv Chaba Rav Sivan Ben Sima V'Toch Kol Shal Cholei Yisrael. I want to start with the halacha from Hanukkah and then relate it to the first pasuk of our parsha. The halacha teaches where we light the candles, and when we try to think about where we do something, we know that the place that we're doing something is the will we have of how we want the action to affect us. So for example, where we get married is in a beautiful scenery because we want the scenery to affect the emotional state of the wedding. So same too, when we choose where to light the Hanukkah candles, there's obviously a message of how we want to view the candles through where we're lighting them. So in Masechet Shabbat of Kaf Aleph Amud Bet, the Gemara says, Mitzvat Ner Chanukah, Petach Beito Mi Bachutz. That the place that we light the candles are Petach Beito Mi Bachutz. So to understand these three words gives us an understanding of the Hanukkah candles. What is Petach Beito? Petach Beito is the border between your family and the world. And I don't know where I am. And I'm in the place of tension between my comfort of my family and the discomfort and the fear and the difficulty of the greater world. But the Gemara adds in another word. And it says, not only is it in Petach Beito, but it needs to be Mi Bachutz. That the direction is to be aware of the tension, but davka for the candles to go out from the home a little bit. So what I try to understand is, why is it important for the Hanukkah candles to be mi bachutz? And I think there's a very strong message in Hanukkah. I think very often we view the outside world as a problem. We go there if we need to. It's something that we sort of like stray away from. The lower level people will be outside or whatever it is. But our general vision of the outside is a place that you need to overcome, but it's not a place that you learn from or a place that you grow in. Comes Hanukkah and says, the outside is an opportunity. And the Hanukkah candles need to be mibachutz because there's something that you need to internalize about the outside. The outside exposes a person to questions. It exposes a person to vulnerability, to the feeling of, I'm not sure where I am. Comes Hanukkah and teaches you that mi bachutz is not a bad thing. That when I learned in Yeshivat Otniel and all the walls were built out of glass, the message was that the outside is something that we're aware of. That the PSS and the Rebbe says that every Beit Midrash needs to be aware not just of what's going on inside, but to understand that the outside is part of their world. You cannot remove yourself from the outside. And so therefore the Hanukkah candles are forcing us to understand that the outside is not a place that we run away from, but it's a place that we have to embrace. It's a place that we have to learn from, and it's a place that we have to be a part of. Even if it's difficult, we need to know the outside. Comes our parsha, and then the Sfarim met together, and the opening pasuk is vayeshev Yaakov be'eretz megurei aviv be'eretz Kanan. There are two things in this pasuk that are not needed. The word vayeshev is not needed. Why is it not needed? I need to know that he was in the land of Israel. So say v'Yaakov be'eretz Kanan, and I know where he is. The addition of the word vayeshev is obviously teaching us that there's something else going on here. And so it says in Sfarim met, what's the addition of vayeshev? And he says that the idea of vayeshev is p'chinat Shabbat. Right, that the idea of Lashevet is this concept of a world of Shabbat, of comfort, of relaxation, a feeling of I'm not struggling. So it says this, Sfarim met, she'ad atah, till now, haya avodot kashot.